Today we're going to talk about buttons in Coda. Personally, buttons are my favorite thing about Coda, so I'm really excited to make this video and show you guys what they are from a foundational level and then show you some tricks and why you should really be using them in every single document you have. So, let's go. First, what are buttons? Buttons are exactly what you would think. It's a button you press. You can see here, this is a button. It looks so clickable. I'm gonna quickly click it over and over again and again. Buttons allow you to perform actions inside of your doc or outside, such as sending Slack messages, sending emails, adding rows, modifying rows, opening hyperlinks, and so many other things. They really are the key to making your documents feel like applications and helping them work and move smoothly. If you want great documents, use buttons. Let's look at them. All right, first off, there's two places that we can have buttons in our documents. The first is called the canvas. The canvas, people often ask me, what the heck is that? Well, it's any part of your document outside of a table. So this is a table, and inside of a table, I can have a button. So let's make a button here. It is a column type. I can search for button and insert a button onto my table. And then if I insert a button anywhere else outside of a table, that is a canvas-based button. They're pretty much the same thing. Slight differences, we'll get into it. But let's start looking at what they can do. So first off, let's just look at the components of a button. What makes up a button? Then we're gonna move to examples of what they can do. If I open this button, I right-click on it, I have a couple things. First off is my onClick. So first you define what a button can or should or will do. You drop it down and you can see there are a whole bunch of things it can do. Add rows, add or modify rows, duplicate rows, delete rows, copy to clipboard, duplicate page, copy page to doc, open hyperlink, open row, send message, push button, sign up for Coda, set control value, reset, and more. And then you get to packs. And you can see that this button can actually perform actions outside of your document in so many different services. There's over 600 different packs, so there's a lot of things your buttons can do. But let's just say that this one is going to copy to clipboard. What do we want it to copy? We want it to copy to the user's clipboard. You are a very special person. Believe in yourself, all right? So that's the first element of a button, is what does the button do when it's pressed? The next section is visual. So visual allows you to define how your button looks and acts. And let's say the label is copy a special message. You can then give it an icon. You can give it no icon, or you can give it any icon you want. Let's make it secret. And color, I usually like these tones, but if you want to give it some pop, give it a pop. And then this size, this is only relevant for canvas-based buttons, not for these buttons. So if you go to this button, you should see the same things on click, but you'll see no size here. Column-based buttons are always the same size. But let's go ahead and make this one large. Okay, copy a special message. You'll see now that when I press it, and now if I press Command-V on my keyboard, it's gonna copy and now paste that for myself. Let's look at the last component of a button, and that is going to be advanced. So in the advanced section, we're gonna find a couple different things. First off is its name. Pretty much you don't have to worry about this. There are circumstances if you get really into building more application-like things with Coda, you'll have to worry about this. But I can just call this whatever I want it to be called. I'm gonna say special message. This allows you to do things like having another button, click another button. So I'm just gonna say on click, do special message. So now because I'm accessing special message, this button will actually do the same thing. That's what the name does. It allows us to refer to it later. Not important, pretty much just ignore it. Disable if. This is easily the most important part about a button. It allows you to make the button unpressable. Why the heck would you want a button that's unpressable? Seems kind of counterintuitive. Oh my goodness, for so many reasons. You're gonna see why in a couple minutes in this video. We're gonna make this one silly. We're gonna say today.weekday name is equal to, what is today? I'm filming this on Friday. So you'll see that today is Friday. When I'm filming this, now I can't press it anymore. You can define any number of criteria inside there. Now I'm gonna say not Friday, and you'll see now it's pressable. Last is a badge. I don't use these. You can use them if they want. You could literally just say, now, kind of silly, gives you a little badge here. Usually it's meant to be a count. So maybe it's the number of times someone's pressed it. I could say sequence from 1 to 6, average. And now my badge is 3.5. It just throws up this little blue thing. It really only and should work for numbers. I don't use it that often. Take it or leave it. Lastly, you've got an alert. So you'll notice that when I press this pink button here, this message down at the bottom of the screen showed up. Sometimes that's nice. Sometimes it is so annoying. So by default, it's on. You have a couple different states that you can set for it. And that's going to be, do you want that to show every time, never, or only for errors? Depending on how complicated your buttons are, they can perform errors. So I usually press only for errors. Then I know that I've done it. All right, so that's the component of a button. You may be like, great, so what? How and where am I gonna use this? I'm gonna show you a couple different ways that you can or should be using these in your document. So let's go ahead and look at our buttons here. This is a task table. On our task table, maybe we want to create a button that changes the status of a task to completed. So maybe we have here our tables only showing tasks that are not completed. Now I'm going to come here and I'm going to make a button that's called done exclamation point. I'm going to come here and I am going to select an action. When I select my action, this is going to be a modify rows, right? So this button is going to modify a row. I now have to tell it what table or row do I want to modify. Usually the answer is this row, the row that the button's on. And then you get to determine how the row itself is modified. On this one, we're going to update the status to, I'm not going to just say completed because someone might change that name. I'm going to press the equal button on my keyboard and use my completed object. The reason why that is good is because then if I change the word completed to done, it doesn't break anything. Now you'll see if I go back to this modify rows, that object dynamically updates to that level, where if I just put it the word completed, it would have broken it. So little trick for you. Aren't you glad you watched this far? Next up then, we're gonna make this make sense. So right now it just says modify rows, dumb. I'm gonna actually do nothing and I'm just gonna give a green check. Meh. And I'm going to make this green because green is good and good is done. Now what I'm going to do is make this a little bit skinnier. You'll see now I have this done button next to my task. Maybe I'll put it way up at the top and I will press done. Woohoo! All right. That's great. I love that. So next up, disable criteria. Why would you want to make a button not pressable? Here's one example. Maybe you only want this button to be pressed if you are in the assignee column. Obviously, this is not my task. This is Daniel. I am not Daniel. I should not be able to mark his task as done. Well, okay, let's go here. Let's go here, edit column. Me, I want to advance disable criteria if the assignee does not contain the current user. So now you'll see that these two buttons are not clickable for me because these two buttons, this task is assigned to Daniel and Aaron. I am not Daniel. I am not Aaron. I cannot click them. But as soon as I am one of the assignees, you'll see that that becomes clickable for me. And now I can mark that task as done. So that's in one area where you may want to use buttons. Let's talk about another really compelling way to use a button. Let's say you have a team directory. You're building this out for your team. This is going to be a Canvas-based button. You don't want to have one of your HR staff members have to update and add to this team directory every single time you hire someone new. No, you want to give people the power to add themselves. So we're going to add a Canvas-based button in to here. We're going to make it big. We're going to say, we're going to say some really cool stuff here. Pretty much everywhere in Coda, you can take static values. This is a static value. That static value doesn't change, but you can make it a formula. So we're actually going to, we want a button to add a user, but you're probably going to have a troll that you work with, right? And they're going to add themselves a million times. We don't want someone to add themselves a million times. So instead, you're going to disable this button if they've already been there. So let's first have this add a row to our team. When this button adds a row, it's going to add the person as the equal to user. Woohoo. So you'll see here that I am not yet in this table. Boom. Now I am in the table via that button press, but you don't want to troll or someone to just accidentally add themselves multiple times. So let's modify how this button works, and you're going to see some really cool stuff here. All right, first off, let's make the label different. Let's say this is going to be if the current logged in user is inside of a list of the people who are on that table, then say, you already there, fool. If not, say, add me. Great. And lastly, we'll put that on the disable criteria too. We'll disable this if the user is inside of our team.person. Woo. All right. Next, you'll see here, this also allows you to open the row for editing. That's nice because if I just add it like this, meh, you already there, fool. Then how do I edit myself? Well, okay, let's delete card. Let's open the row for editing, meh, add me. It now both adds my row and provides me the rest of the information, the fun stuff. I love Coda. All right, now I can X out and now I'm in here and the button won't let me add one more time. I'm gonna show you one more thing. You've learned the foundations 101 on buttons, but we're gonna now show you how to create a complex button, a button that both does multiple things at the same time, as well as sends a Slack message. So we're gonna learn how to use packs and buttons. So please stick around for this last part. So let's go back to our task and let's pretend that you wanna mark this as done. But let's say you want to both mark the task as done and you want that to automate a Slack message to go out. Let's talk about how you do that. So I can make another button. This is the easiest way to do it. I'm gonna call send Slack message. So I'm gonna create a button, column type, button. I'm gonna make it new. On my actions, I'm gonna go down to packs and I'll go to Slack. Slack isn't here, lame. Let's do send message or notify user. This is the same thing. It allows us to send a Slack message. It's called a pack. Packs are integrations with Coda. We'll add it to the doc. Next up, you get to define the message for the Slack message. And you could say, hey everyone, the task at task name is so done. We're gonna define the channel. I'm gonna send that to general biz. That's a name in our Slack. Wonderful. Now I'm gonna make sure that my account is connected. Let's do that. There we go. Good to go, good to go, good to go, good to go. But I want this to be sent when it's marked done. But what I don't want is to have to ask my people to press both of these buttons at the same time. That is super lame. So what I'm gonna do instead is add one more column before. I'm gonna call it super done. You probably don't wanna call yours super done, but you know, whatever. We're gonna call ours super done. I'm gonna make it a button, and this button is gonna do multiple things. It's actually going to push buttons. The buttons this is going to push both the done button and the send Slack message button. Probably wanna make this green. And we'll keep that on. That's kind of fun. Super done. Now I would go ahead and I would hide this. Hide. And I would hide this. We don't need to see those buttons. All we need is this super bun done. Super done button. I could then come here. Press that. You'll see that it says one row modified and one Slack message sent. Really cool. Because now our button is doing multiple things, including pack actions. That is just an introduction to buttons. Buttons are honestly one of the most powerful things inside of Coda. There's even a hidden secret button formula. Button, burp. You'll see that it is secret and hidden, and I'm not going to tell you how to use it. If you're interested in how to use this and take your button skills even farther, comment in the comments below. Let me know what you got. Adios.